Good evening. I'm Tom Hudson. Susie has the evening off. Also weighing a bit on stocks today, some higher anxiety about third quarter profits. U.S. corporate earnings have outpaced the broad economy since the end of the Great Recession. But profit warnings yesterday from Caterpillar and recently from Intel, FedEx, and Burberry all suggest the boom in earnings may be beginning to fizzle. Suzanne Pratt tonight takes a closer look at how the numbers are shaping up for the third quarter and beyond.
The start of reporting season for corporate America is still 2 weeks away, but already on Wall Street, worries about corporate profits are heating up. And it looks like investors have good reason to be nervous.
After all, analysts predict companies in the S&P 500 will see earnings drop an average of 2% in the third quarter. If that happens, it will be the first such decline in 3 years. Tough comparisons are partly responsible, as last year's third quarter was one of the best ever. On top of that, however, global demand remains weak.
I think we're just seeing a lot of issues finally mounting, things that started in 2010 and 2011 that are really starting to hit companies' bottom lines. Mainly the sovereign debt crisis in Europe just doesn't seem to be going away.
Curiously, though, the stock market is more than holding its own despite the darkening cloud of corporate profits. Investment pro Wayne Kaufman says central banks have helped underpin stocks, but he adds investors won't ignore weakening profits forever.
I think they will give a pass this quarter unless they're extremely bad and the guidance is really dire. The market's only going to give a pass on earnings for so long because at the end of the day, you do have to have good valuations.
The market may also be staying strong because the outlook for fourth quarter profits is brighter. Even though the number has recently slipped, analysts believe S&P 500 earnings will grow a respectable 10% in the quarter that begins next week. Still, not everyone thinks it's an achievable goal.
And I really expect that number will come back a bit. Once more companies report for the third quarter, I really do think analysts will start to revise fourth quarter estimates down quite a bit.
As for corporate profits next year, analysts are pretty optimistic, predicting on average an increase of 12% for the S&P 500. Will it hold? That depends on the global economy. Suzanne Pratt, NBR, New York.